this video, I'll be showing you how to replace your conventional cold control with a full gauge MT-512. This replaces your defrost timer, temperature control, and thermometer. First thing we have to do is remove the old cold control here and jump the two wires that are connected to it. Let's put all this back together. So that's all we got inside the cabinet, just to jump those two wires from the old cold control. Next step is to find the cord in here. It's right back there. And this is the cord coming from the condenser that plugs into that switch box right there. And this wire up here is the wire that goes out to the conventional cold control that we just jumped. And since we jumped the wires in that cold control, now that junction block has power all the time. It's straight power, it's unswitched. And this is where we're gonna get our power for our full gauge control. It's the controller intersection here. This side of the splice is gonna be our power supply, and this side of the splice is the load to our compressor. So I'll just go over these one by one. This is gonna be our neutral for our controller, which is spliced into the neutral side of the plug. Next is going to be our compressor load. This is our compressor load, which is gonna go connected to our refrigeration terminal on our controller. And this is gonna be our hot coming from our power supply. And what I usually do is I put two wires on that one just for convenience. So one goes in each terminal. So what we got is we got the red, which is gonna supply our relay for our refrigeration circuit. And then we have the black, which is gonna supply power to our controller. Next, I'm gonna hook up all those wires to the terminals right here on the controller. I'm just gonna prep these wires right here for connection to our controller. So you should have about 6 millimeters or 1/4 inch of wire exposed. And that's a good rule of thumb, because once you put it in this terminal, the actual conductor accommodates the full depth of the terminal. And then the insulation on the wire butts right up against the insulation of the terminal block. And that eliminates possibility of a short circuit. That's it for our connections. I'm just gonna do a quick overview. So 0 is gonna be neutral, coming from our power supply. 115 is coming from the hot side of our power supply, unswitched. Red is also coming from our hot power supply, unswitched. And that's powering our common for our refrigeration circuit. And then green is our compressor load. So now that I'm done connecting all the wires, the next thing to do is install the temperature sensor right here. Just drop this little sensor right in the cabinet, and the other side goes connected directly to the controller, and then we can power it up and program the controller. Stick that sucker through the hole, and we'll just put some little, we'll put some mastic here just to cover the hole in there. We're just gonna drop that down into the box. Last thing we're gonna connect are those sensor wires. The only thing we have left now to do is mount this controller. We're just gonna use some strapping and kind of strap it up here. It's unfortunate that these units don't come with an electronic controller already, but if they did, we wouldn't have to retrofit it. So now it's finally strapped up in there real nice and neat. Next thing to do is connect this plug right over here. Next step is to program the controller. First, we'll set the unit of measure to centigrade. And the way we do that is we're gonna hit the up and down arrow keys simultaneously. So we get function, we're gonna hit set, and then go to 231. We're gonna hit set, functional one, then we're gonna hit the up key once, and then we're gonna hit set again. And here's our centigrade Fahrenheit. Now we're gonna hit the up key again till we get the Fahrenheit symbol. And then we hit set one more time, and now we're in Fahrenheit. And I'll show you real quick. We just hold the set key, and that's gonna take us back to the home screen. You're gonna see it's in Fahrenheit now. There we go, 63. And next we'll go into the settings menu to change our settings. Now we're gonna hold the up and down key simultaneously one more time. Then once we get function 01, we hit set, and then the code for our settings menu is 123. Okay, now we're gonna hit set. That's gonna bring us back to the function menu. And the first thing we have to set is going to be F05, which is our differential. We're gonna use a differential of 5 right there. Hit set to save the setting. F06 is gonna be our short cycle delay, which right now is 20 seconds. So we're gonna set this to about 60 seconds. F07 is going to be our refrigeration time in minutes. It's 240. So we're gonna go and change that to 360, which is gonna be every 6 hours. Next is gonna be F08, which is our defrost time. So we're gonna leave it at 30 minutes, which is our default. And these are the only settings we have to change for this installation, is the defrost time, refrigeration time, short cycle delay, and differential. Now let's go back to the menu by holding the set key. That's gonna take us back to the main menu. I just wanna show you a couple features of this controller really quickly. This particular controller has a feature where you can force it into refrigeration or defrost mode. And we do that by holding the up key. Just hold it, hold it, hold it, wait for it. Bam, now it's in defrost. If we wanna put it back in refrigeration mode again, all we have to do is hold this up key, hold it, hold it, hold it. And bam, we're back in refrigeration again. That pretty much wraps it up. You can see how easy it is to replace a conventional cold control with a full gauge MT-512 digital controller. Until next time, I'm Matt Micah. Thanks for watching Full Gauge Chronicles.